Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Indonesian ebook before it's gone.
In this video, you'll learn 20 of the most common words and phrases in Indonesian. Hi everybody, my name is Blanca. Welcome to the 800 Core Indonesian Words and Phrases video series. This series will teach you the 800 most common words and phrases in Indonesian. But there's a twist. With each new lesson in this series, we'll include the previous lessons at the end. So after you've learned the new words and phrases, stick around and review what you learned in previous lesson. Reviewing is one of the most important parts of learning a language. You can also get the full list right now at the IndonesianPod101.com. Click the link in the description to access more example sentences, create your own flashcard deck, and finally, master Indonesian. Okay, let's get started. First is, halo. Hello. Halo. Halo. Hello. Halo, bisa saya berbicara dengan Anna? Hello, can I speak to Anna? Halo, bisa saya berbicara dengan Anna? Permisi. Excuse me. Permisi. Permisi. Excuse me. Permisi. Apakah kamu melihat anjing saya? Excuse me. Have you seen my dog? Permisi. Apakah kamu melihat anjing saya? Saya minta maaf. I'm sorry. Saya minta maaf. Saya minta maaf. I'm sorry. Saya minta maaf, dia tidak berada di sini sekarang. I'm sorry, he is not here right now. Saya minta maaf, dia tidak berada di sini sekarang. Selamat malam. Good night. Selamat malam. Selamat malam. Good night. Selamat malam dan terima kasih banyak. Good night and thank you very much. Selamat malam dan terima kasih banyak. Senang bertemu dengan Anda. Nice to meet you. Senang bertemu dengan Anda. Senang bertemu dengan Anda. Nice to meet you. Senang bertemu dengan Anda, Pak. Nice to meet you, sir. Senang bertemu dengan Anda, Pak. Apa kabar? How are you? Apa kabar? Apa kabar? How are you? Selamat siang, Mas. Apa kabar? Good day, brother. How are you? Selamat siang, Mas. Apa kabar? Iya. Yes. Iya. Iya. Yes. Iya. Rasanya enak. Yes. It's nice. Iya. Rasanya enak. Tidak. No. Tidak. Tidak. No. Tidak. Saya tidak bisa berenang. No, I can't swim. Tidak, saya tidak bisa berenang. Terima kasih. Thank you. Terima kasih. Terima kasih. Thank you. Katakan terima kasih. Say thank you. Katakan terima kasih. Saya, I'm, saya, I'm, saya, Lisa, I'm Lisa. Saya Lisa. Selamat tinggal. Goodbye. Selamat tinggal. Selamat tinggal. Goodbye. Selamat tinggal. Sampai bertemu sebentar lagi. Goodbye. See you soon. Selamat tinggal. Sampai bertemu sebentar lagi. Jahat. bad. Jahat. Jahat. Bad. Hati-hati dengan orang yang jahat. Be careful of bad people. Hati-hati dengan orang yang jahat. Baik. Good. Baik. Baik. Good. Dia orang yang baik. She is a good person. Dia orang yang baik. Cantik. Pretty. Cantik. Cantik. Pretty. Tuti pendek, tapi cantik. Tuti is short, but pretty. Tuti pendek, tapi cantik. Jelek. Ugly. Jelek. Jelek. Ugly. Wajah yang jelek. Ugly face. Wajah yang jelek. Mudah. Easy. Mudah. Mudah. Easy. Tas punggung seharusnya ringan dan mudah dibawa. Backpacks should be light and easy to carry. Tas punggung seharusnya ringan dan mudah dibawa. Sulit. Difficult. Sulit. Sulit. Difficult. Ujian hari Rabu akan sulit. Wednesday test will be difficult. Ujian hari Rabu akan sulit. Dekat. Near. Dekat. Dekat. Near. Saya tinggal di dekat universitas. I live near the university. Saya tinggal di dekat universitas. Jauh. Far. Jauh. Jauh. Far. Stasiunnya jauh dari sini. The station is far from here. Stasiunnya jauh dari sini. Kecil. Small. Kecil. Kecil. Small. Sangat kecil. Very small. Sangat kecil. Remember, the goal of this series is to build a vocabulary of the 800 most common words and phrases in Indonesian. If that sounds like a lot, don't worry, we can help you. Click the link in the description to access the full list. You'll also get example sentences, custom flashcard desk, and more learning resource at indonesianpod101.com. See you next time. Selamat tinggal.
Can learning a new language help you make money? In this video, you'll learn three ways that learning a language can help increase your income. So, if you know a language other than your native language, does it help you earn more money? Learning a new language provides a wide range of benefits, including personal growth, higher cognitive function, better resistance to age-related deterioration, and the opportunity to meet exciting new people from all over the world. But that's not all. It's possible that learning a foreign language can help you to earn more money throughout your life. Studies have shown that someone making $30,000 annually could boost their salary by at least $600 per year through applying their knowledge of another language. Over the course of a lifetime, that could add up to a significant contribution to your retirement savings or overall earnings. In this video, we're going to talk about how to get free language learning courses and tools that you can use for your studies, with the aim of boosting your income. One day, the extra money could possibly help you buy a new Ferrari, vacation home, or save more money for retirement. But first, let's look at a few ways you can make money with a second language. The first method is by exploring bilingual or multilingual job opportunities. With the rise of multinational corporations doing business all around the globe, the need for bilingual or even multilingual employees has never been higher. Therefore, knowing a second language can be extremely valuable. Having a second language as part of your skill set could help you make significantly more money than if you're fluent in just one language. So, in a very real way, learning a language online, even for free, can alter your career and earnings trajectory for the better, and it can help put you on the path towards the lifestyle you want. The second method is by exploring work you can do from home in your second language. It's possible to use your knowledge of a second language to work from home. There are many websites that have hundreds of paying translation jobs at any given time. Although the pay may vary significantly between jobs, and you probably won't actually become rich from such work, translation jobs can boost your salary and improve your lifestyle. And translation jobs aren't the only way to make money online from home. There are actually a wide range of opportunities out there for people to boost their income using their knowledge of a second language. These include copywriting, administrative work, and even multilingual IT jobs. The third method is by working overseas. If you love adventure or want to travel the world, you can put your language knowledge to use by taking advantage of bilingual or multilingual opportunities overseas. Put what you've learned to work in the real world. Combine your second language skills with the other skills you have and offer something special to employers. To start, think about a country where you might like to live someday and begin your language studies with the language spoken in that country. With diligent work, you can master a language and secure a position with an overseas company. These are just a few of the ways you can put your knowledge of another language to use and make some extra money with your skills. Over time, this added income can make a huge difference in your life. Our language learning program provides a number of free language learning tools and resources as part of our free lifetime account. You can use these to get started with your language learning and begin working toward boosting your income throughout your life. So, if you're ready to finally learn a new language the fast, fun, and easy way, sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Signing up takes less than 30 seconds, and you'll start speaking from your very first lesson. If you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye!
In this video, you'll learn 20 of the most common words and phrases in Indonesian. Hi everybody, my name is Blanca. Welcome to the 800 Core Indonesian Words and Phrases video series. This series will teach you the 800 most common words and phrases in Indonesian. But there's a twist. With each new lesson in this series, we'll include the previous lessons at the end. So after you've learned the new words and phrases, stick around and review what you learned in previous lessons. Reviewing is one of the most important parts of learning a language. You can also get the full list right now at IndonesianPod101.com. Click the link in the description to access more example sentences, create your own flashcard deck, and finally master Indonesian. Okay, let's get started. First is hari ini. Today. Hari ini. Hari ini. Today. Hari ini langit cerah. Today the sky is clear. Hari ini langit cerah. Kemarin. Yesterday. Kemarin. Kemarin. Yesterday. Saya libur kemarin. I took a day off yesterday. Saya libur kemarin. Besok. Tomorrow. Besok. Besok. Tomorrow. Besok cuaca akan cerah. It will be sunny tomorrow. Besok cuaca akan cerah. Minggu. Week. Minggu. Minggu. Week. Hari Selasa minggu depan. Tuesday next week. Hari Selasa minggu depan. Tahun. Year. Tahun. Tahun. Year. 2000 tahun lalu. 2000 years ago. 2000 tahun lalu. Detik. Second. Detik. Detik. Second. Selama 10 detik. For 10 seconds. Selama 10 detik. Menit. 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 Kecegukan selama 5 menit. Hiccup for 5 minutes. Kecegukan selama 5 menit. Jam. Hour. Jam. Jam. Hour. Perbedaan waktu 2 jam. 2-hour time difference. Perbedaan waktu 2 jam. Jam. Clock. Jam. Jam. Clock. Pasang jam waker. Set an alarm clock. Pasang jam waker. Pukul. O'clock. Pukul. Pukul. O'clock. Sekarang pukul 3. It is 3 o'clock now. Sekarang pukul 3. Kalender. 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 Kalender 1 tahun. One calendar year. Kalender 1 tahun. Senin. Monday. Senin. Senin. Monday. Minggu kerja dimulai setiap Senin. The work week starts on Monday. Minggu kerja dimulai setiap Senin. Selasa, Tuesday. Selasa. Selasa. Tuesday. Tanggal 1 Januari jatuh pada hari Selasa tahun ini. January 1st falls on a Tuesday this year. Tanggal 1 Januari jatuh pada hari Selasa tahun ini. Rabu, Wednesday. Rabu. Rabu. Wednesday. Ujian hari Rabu akan sulit. Wednesday test will be difficult. Ujian hari Rabu akan sulit. Kamis. Thursday. Kamis. Kamis. Thursday. Kamis 3 Januari. Thursday, January 3rd. Kamis 3 Januari. Jumat. Friday. Jumat. Jumat. Friday. Makan di luar hari Jumat. Eat out on Friday. Makan di luar hari Jumat. Sabtu. Saturday. Sabtu. Sabtu. Saturday. Tidak ada rencana untuk hari Sabtu. No plans for Saturday. Tidak ada rencana untuk hari Sabtu. Minggu. Sunday. Minggu. Minggu. Sunday. Hari Minggu sungguh menenangkan. Sundays are very relaxing. Hari Minggu sungguh menenangkan. Mengerjakan. Do. Mengerjakan. Ngerjakan. Do. Saya harus mengerjakan banyak pekerjaan hari ini. I have to do a lot of work today. Saya harus mengerjakan banyak pekerjaan hari ini. Pergi. Go. Pergi. Pergi. Go. Kalau kamu pergi, saya pergi. If you go, I go. Kalau kamu pergi, saya pergi. Remember, the goal of this series is to build a vocabulary of the 800 most common words and phrases in Indonesian. If that sounds like a lot, don't worry. We can help you. Click the link in the description to access the full list. You'll also get example sentences, custom flashcard decks, and more learning resources at indonesianpod101.com. See you next time. Selamat tinggal.
Not enough time in the day. This is one of the biggest reasons people struggle with learning a language. Sure, you want to speak the language fluently, but you're already busy with work, school, relationships, TV shows, and goals that you just can't give up on. But the truth is, if you're going out and commuting, then you actually do have a bit of time, which is actually enough to learn a language if you're learning the right way. 5 easy ways to learn while on a walk or on your commute. So in this guide, you'll discover how you can learn a language and make meaningful progress on your walks or commutes, and how to apply these tips to our learning system, but you can also apply them to your other resources. But first, if you don't yet have access to our language learning system, sign up for a free lifetime account right now. Just click the link in the description to get your free lifetime account. So, how can you learn on a commute or a 10-minute walk? Number one. Download our free app, Innovative Language Learning. If you're already thinking that getting an app is obvious, you're right. But many apps out there require you to be actively tapping and using your device, which may not be good if your commute involves driving. With Innovative Language Learning, you can just press play on a lesson and listen to practical conversations in your target language, all hands-free. You hear real speakers, real voices. And then our teachers explain all the words and grammar rules from the conversation while you're walking or even driving. Each lesson is just a few minutes long, meaning you can learn quite a bit on a 10-minute commute. Number two, boost your vocabulary with the word of the day. This is another thing you can do on the go. Our free Word of the Day email lessons are sent daily, and all you have to do is open up your phone, check the email, and learn the word. And that only takes a minute, or less. Many of our existing learners like this study tool, because even if they're too busy to do anything else, keeping up with the Word of the Day still keeps them on track with the language. Everyone that signs up to our learning system gets the free Word of the Day automatically. So if you want the study tool, just click the link in the description. Number three, swipe through our vocabulary and phrase images. You know how you open up your Photos app and swipe through to look at your pictures? Well, you can do just that and learn words and phrases at the same time with our infographics. Just download our free infographics. These contain several words per image, so you're not learning just one word at a time. And then swipe through while you're on a walk or on a commute. Of course, you can do this with other resources too, like our PDF cheat sheets. Number four, listen to words and phrases on repeat with our audio slideshow. Just visit our free vocabulary lists inside the menu. Pick a list and select Play Slideshow. You can set this slideshow on a loop and play the words and phrases over and over while you're out on the go. And number five, learn with your teacher on the go. If you're a Premium Plus member, you can also use our app to interact with your teacher, ask questions, make recordings of yourself speaking, and get corrections. Just tap on My Teacher on the bottom menu. Many of our learners will spend a few minutes sending questions about grammar they've learned in the lessons, and others send quick write-ups about their day for corrections. So go ahead and try any one of these tips and learn a bit of the language while you're out on the go. And if you want to get access to these resources and our learning system, sign up for a free lifetime account right now. Just click the link in the description to get your free lifetime account. Most adults shy away from language learning for one obvious reason. Learning a language takes time. But just because you're busy doesn't mean you can't start learning a language. You just need the right tools that help you make the most of your limited time. How to learn easily for busy adults. And that's why, in this guide, you'll discover 1. How to pick up practical conversations in just a few minutes a day. 2. How to boost your vocabulary for free. 3. Apps to use to learn on the go. And 4. The one self-made trap that stops most people, including busy adults, from learning. But first, if you don't yet have access to our language learning system, sign up for a free lifetime account right now. Just click the link in the description to get your free lifetime account. So, here's how you can start learning a language as a busy adult. And the first point is... the all-or-nothing mindset is when you think either you succeed or you fail, and there's no in-between. This kind of black or white thinking is common with perfectionists and those with high anxiety. And in the case of language learning, someone with this mindset will think, there's no point in learning for 10 or 15 minutes a day because it takes a lot of time. So either you go all out and study for hours a day, or you don't bother at all. And of course, the problem is nobody starts learning a language by going all out, just like nobody lifts 200 pounds on their first day at the gym. And even if you tried, you wouldn't last very long. Do you have this mindset? Leave us a comment. But before you start learning a language, try and change your mind about this, because it's much easier to stick with language as a habit and grow that habit if you're not overwhelming yourself from the start. Now, how can you learn if you're busy? If you're learning with our system, you get lessons by real teachers that are just 3 to 15 minutes in length. And in those few minutes, you 1. Hear a practical conversation. 2. Get every word and grammar rule explained. 3. Have the conversation repeated several times just to help it stick. 4. Learn cultural tips related to the lesson. And 5. You start speaking the language. So for those few minutes, you get the best possible return for the time you put in, which is great for busy adults. And after you're done with lesson number 1, we guide you to lesson 2 to 3, from absolute beginner all the way up to advanced. If you want to learn to speak the language without getting bogged down with grammar, then check out our Survival Phrases course. You'll learn basic conversations and phrases needed to survive in the country, like greetings, how to order food, how to ask for directions, and more. Again, lessons are just a few minutes long, and they're perfect for travelers, busy adults, and anyone looking for an easy start to the language. By the way, this 50-lesson Survival Phrases course is 100% free for all users until June 30th, so don't miss out on this freebie. It won't be available for long. Now, if you're always on the go and prefer using your phone, then download our app, Innovative Language Learning, for free. And this gives you the same access to all the lessons inside our system. That way, you can easily do a few lessons on your commute, on a break, or on a walk. The Word of the Day is a free service that sends you new words every day and improves your vocabulary. And you can easily spend a minute or two reading through the word, the examples, listening to the pronunciation, and saying it out loud. These are just a few ways you can start learning a language, even if you're low on time. So, if you want to learn the language and get access to these learning tools and our learning system, sign up for a free lifetime account right now. Just click the link in the description to get your free lifetime account. Remember, here's what you can do to learn all of these words by heart. Drill these words with our spaced repetition flashcards, which will help cement these words into your long-term memory. Save them to the Word Bank, your personal vocabulary collection, where you can print out your own study sheets, or review the words with our looped vocabulary slideshow, and play it until you know all of the words. So click the link in the description right now and sign up for your free lifetime account to get these lessons and study tools.
In this video, you'll learn 20 of the most common words and phrases in Indonesian. Hi everybody, my name is Blanca. Welcome to the 800 Core Indonesian Words and Phrases video series. This series will teach you the 800 most common words and phrases in Indonesian. But there's a twist. With each new lesson in the series, we'll include the previous lessons at the end. So after you've learned the new words and phrases, stick around and review what you learned in previous lessons. Reviewing is one of the most important parts of learning a language. You can also get the full list right now at IndonesianPod101.com. Click the link in the description to access more example sentences, create your own flashcard deck, and finally, master Indonesian. Okay, let's get started. First is tangan, hand, tangan, tangan, hand, tanganmu dingin sekali. Your hands are so cold. Tanganmu dingin sekali. Lengan. Arm. Lengan. Lengan. Arm. Robot itu sedang menggerakkan lengannya. The robot is moving its arms. Robot itu sedang menggerakkan lengannya. Kaki, foot, kaki, kaki, foot. Dokter itu sedang memeriksa kaki. The doctor is examining the foot. Dokter itu sedang memeriksa kaki. Kaki. Leg. Kaki. Kaki. Leg. Kaki panjang. Long legs. Kaki panjang. Jari tangan. Finger. Jari tangan. Jari tangan. Finger. Jari saya Berdarah. My fingers bleeding. Jari saya berdarah. Punggung. Back. Punggung. Punggung. Back. Punggung landak diselimuti duri-duri tajam. A hedgehog's back is covered in sharp spines. Punggung landak diselimuti duri-duri tajam. Perut. Stomach. Perut. Perut. Stomach. Kemarin perut saya sakit sekali. Yesterday, I had a bad stomach ache. Kemarin perut saya sakit sekali. Dada. Chest. Dada. Dada. Chest. Ronsen dada. X-ray of a chest. Ronsen dada. January. 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 Di sini dingin sekali bulan Januari. It's very cold here in January. Di sini dingin sekali bulan Januari. February. 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 Hari tahun Kabisat jatuh pada tanggal 29 Februari. Leap Year Day is February 29th. Hari tahun Kabisat jatuh pada tanggal 29 Februari. Maret. March. Maret. Maret. March. Sekarang April. Jadi, bulan yang lalu, Maret. It is now April, so last month was March. Sekarang April. Jadi, bulan yang lalu Maret. April.
April.
April. April.
April.
Hujan di bulan April menghadirkan bunga di bulan Mei. April showers bring May flowers. Hujan di bulan April menghadirkan bunga di bulan Mei.
Mei.
Mei. Mei. Mei.
Mei.
Saya lulus sekolah bulan Mei, jadi saya mau mencari pekerjaan. I graduate from school in May, so I want to find a job. Saya lulus sekolah bulan Mei, jadi saya mau mencari pekerjaan.
Juni.
June.
Juni.
Juni.
June.
Kami akan menikah di bulan Juni.
We are getting married in June.
Kami akan menikah di bulan Juni.
Juli.
July.
Juli.
Juli.
July.
Bulan Juli dinamakan menurut Julius Caesar yang lahir di bulan Juli.
July is named for Julius Caesar, who was born in July.
Bulan Juli dinamakan menurut Julius Caesar yang lahir di bulan Juli.
Agustus.
August.
Agustus.
Agustus.
August.
Cuacanya lembab di bulan Agustus.
It's humid in August.
Cuacanya lembab di bulan Agustus.
September.
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 Hari ini hari Sabtu, tanggal 10 September.
Today is Saturday, September 10th.
Hari ini hari Sabtu, tanggal 10 September. October.
October.
October. October.
October.
Tanggal 13 Oktober.
On October 13.
Tanggal 13 Oktober. November.
November.
November. November.
November.
November adalah salah satu dari 4 bulan yang memiliki 30 hari.
November is one of 4 months with 30 days.
November adalah salah satu dari 4 bulan yang memiliki 30 hari.
Desember.
Desember. Desember. Desember.
Desember.
Bulan Desember tahun ini saya akan pulang.
By December of this year, I'll be home.
Bulan Desember tahun ini saya akan pulang.
Remember, the goal of this series is to build a vocabulary of the 800 most common words and phrases in Indonesian. If that sounds like a lot, don't worry, we can help you. Click the link in the description to access the full list. You'll also get example sentences, custom flashcard decks, and more learning resources at indonesianpod101.com. See you next time. Selamat tinggal!
Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Indonesian ebook before it's gone.